Hello there, you gorgeous person. You, this is Chris from Macombo, and I'm here with the Asus Zenfone 6. Definitely the most compelling Zenfone of all time, thanks to its very unique flip camera hardware. Don't have a clue what I'm banging on about? Well, just stay tuned because we're going to give it a full unboxing now. Tour the hardware, the software, and of course that very sexy camera tech. And for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech, don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell. So first of all, flip camera, yeah, it's pretty much giving away the game right there. Let's see what we actually get in here. Oh, I've just absolutely smashed that to bits. That was pretty poor. This beautiful box, and I've already ruined it, god damn it. Good to see you get a PokePin device though, and it has got the Asus brand on it. Lovely stuff. Get the usual user guide. That is a big fat mama right there, Jesus. Look at the size of this thing. It must be in about 20 different languages. More literature as well, and you do get a lovely bit of cover action as well. Nice transparent bumper. Of course, got a very deep and rather unique notch right at the top there, and that is of course to accommodate the flip camera, which we'll be checking out very soon. Apologies also for the sort of gorilla setup for this one. I am actually in a hotel room in Valencia because that's where they did the launch. I literally got my hands on this bad boy about 20 minutes ago, so looking forward to this. There is the actual phone itself. The tagline is Defy Ordinary. Well, it's definitely not ordinary. You certainly cannot accuse it of being that. Got the latest Snapdragon 855 in it, 6.4-inch display with Corning Gorilla Glass 6. Sorry, I've had a couple of beers tonight as well, so this might be a bit of a struggle. And of course, that gorgeous camera tech as well. So I've got the black model. It is also available in a kind of a blue coloration as well. I'll just stick that aside, check out what you get in the rest of the box. I'm guessing power cable, and that's probably about it. So yes, indeedies, you do get, it's a European plug, of course, because this is a European review model, but obviously you'll get the 3-pin if you buy it in the UK and all of that. You get your Type-C USB, and you do actually get a pair of bundled earphones as well, and at least they've actually got some proper rubbery tips as well, because the old hard shell ones are generally pretty nasty on the old lug holes. Right, that took about half an hour to reassemble. Quite an action-packed box there, for sure. So let's get this bad boy all set up. We're not Italian, we're definitely United Kingdom. Let's go. So I've just actually finished setting up the Zenfone 6. Let's take a bit of a tour of the hardware before we dive too much into the software and the various features and everything. So as you can see, it's a nice glass finish here on the back. It does scuff up a storm, as typical glass handsets do, unfortunately. Greasy prints all over that lovely shiny surface. And but like the bit of branding, I think that looks quite snazzy. Of course, got your rear mounted fingerprint sensor there as well, which just falls naturally under your finger when you pick it up, and just a quick tap and boom, into the desktop. It's nice and quick and easy. And there, of course, up top is that cheeky little flip camera, which we will definitely dive into in a sec. I'm gonna keep you on the edge of your seat though and just explore some of the rest of the hardware. It's also very exciting to see a 3.5mm headphone jack, hooray! So that's always good to see. Bit Type-C action, of course, to charge back up, and your bottom mounted speaker grill. It does actually have a stereo speaker setup, the Asus Zenfone 6, so that's good news if you do enjoy watching a bit of video on the go, things like that. Now, of course, because you've got that flip camera action, that means you've got this entire front filling display right here, no little notch action or little pinhole cameras or anything like that. It's a 6.4-inch IPS display, full HD plus resolution, so as you can see, nice and crisp, and super bright as well. I mean, this is on like 15% brightness right now. It's already absolutely fine, perfectly legible. Boost that all the way up to maximum, and basically, I apologize, your eyeballs have probably burst into flames, Raiders of the Lost Ark style back home. Yeah, that is mighty, mighty powerful. So definitely if you live in sunnier climes than the UK, such as this here, Valencia, then you'll probably do quite well with that. One of the other things that I absolutely love about the Zenfone 6 is the fresh new ZenUI 6 as well. It's sat on this thing. Basically, from a quick look at it, you'd be mistaken for thinking it was the Pixel launcher. It's so nice and clean. It is pretty much stock Android. If you dive on into the settings, you get basically all of your typical Android settings in there. You do get a few little tweaks here and there, courtesy of that ZenUI, but basically on the whole, it is pretty much just Google's Android as they intended. So of course you've got all the usual shenanigans, like a bit of digital well-being, just to show you exactly what you're doing with your time and life in general. But you've also got this funky advanced section as well, and that's where a lot of the ZenUI goodies are housed away. So one of the unique features, of course, is the smart key. You'll find this housed over here on the right-hand edge. So you've got your power key down here. It's got a slight blue tint here on this black model, just to help set it apart. You've got your volume rocker, and then you've got your smart key, and it's got a bit of textured surface in there as well. And it is all the way up at the top, but you can just about reach it comfortably with your thumb if you hold it in your right hand, and your fingers if you're holding it in your left hand. And as you can see, you can customize this to do various different bits. By default, it's basically used to call up the Google Assistant, but if you dive into that customization section, as you can see, you can basically set it up to do whatever you want. Turn off the auto-rotate, open up the camera, do a screenshot, all kinds of stuff. So it's great to see that you've got this dedicated customization support for that bonus key. Like, so Game Genie makes a welcome return, so you can do a bit of live streaming to the likes of Twitch and YouTube. And of course, you've got the OptiFlex as well, which just helps to speed up some of the apps that you use more than any others. I'll be doing a full in-depth tips and tricks style thing for this, so stay tuned for that. Now, one of the first major hurrahs about the Asus Zenfone 6 is the fact that it's got 5,000 milliamp battery stuffed inside that relatively slender frame. Very stunning stuff indeed. So that means it's even bigger than the likes of the Huawei P30 Pro, things like that, and it's comparable to the Moto G7 Power, certainly one of the best battery life smartphones of 2019. So hopefully the Zenfone 6 will keep you going for at least a couple of days just with standard use. And of course, you've got the usual battery optimization, power master modes, all that kind of shenanigans as well. And of course, always good to see when you've got a mighty 6+ inch beast like the Zenfone 6, it does have a one-handed mode, thank God, as well, so you can use all of your apps and everything in this mode nice and easy. As for the storage options, you get a choice of either 64, 128, or 256 gigs. As you can see, this review model sits right in the middle of those three. All of which shenanigans, of course, brings us onto that dual lens rear camera tech, which can, of course, flip around to become the front facing camera tech. Do you want to see it in action? Of course you do. Let's just hit this little button here and bosh, there it is. And there's me looking a bit sweaty in my Valencian hotel room. Glamorous life this is. I've got to say, I've only just started playing with this thing and I'm already absolutely obsessed with that funky pop-up camera. It really is very, very slick. It's actually operated by about 13 different gears, apparently, and they had to really refine the technology in order to get it to work. It's been durability tested by small children to make sure they can't just absolutely break it into pieces. And apparently it's good for roughly 100,000 pop-ups as well, which is quite nifty. So basically you can pop it up and down and up and down all day long. So what actually is the camera tech? Well, the primary lens is a 48 megapixel shooter, which uses Sony's IMX586 sensor. So it's the same sensor found on the likes of the OnePlus 7 Pro. So we're expecting some pretty nice looking photos. And you also get a backup 13 megapixel ultra wide angle lens on there as well. You can of course just flip between the two with a quick tap down here. So you go, we're now in ultra wide angle lens mode, 13 megapixels, and as you can see, my bed is an absolute state, my hotel room is a mess. It basically looks like a rock star's been living here, except it's just been a bald northern twat. So obviously the likes of the Pixel 3 smartphones have that dual lens front facing setup with the ultra wide angle effort. Now you've got it here on the Zenfone 6 as well, which is very snazzy. Of course, you've got the likes of the portrait mode as well, which should, you would assume, work really, really well again because you've got that dual lens setup. You've got full pro manual controls and everything as well, so you can have a bit of a fiddle around with the likes of the ISO levels, white balance, all that kind of shenanigans if you want. It looks like quite a pro setup as well. You've got your bit of your level there, bit of histogram action and everything you need. And of course, because the rear camera tech becomes the front facing camera tech, you can also shoot up to 4K resolution video at 60 frames per second of your glorious mug with a nice bit of EIS action as well. And another very funky feature using this camera as well is the fact you can actually control the angle of the camera lenses using the volume keys. So as you can see, you can just raise it up to whatever angle you like, and then you can actually take a picture using that smart key as well, which is pretty nifty. I have noticed that the camera chassis area is starting to get quite toasty now that I've been using the old flip action for a good sort of 10 minutes or so, just playing around with it. It'll be interesting to see how that one holds up. Hopefully it'll be absolutely fine. I mean, obviously you wouldn't be playing around with it this much in everyday life, you wouldn't have thought. And also last but very much not least, you've got a bit of Snapdragon 855 chipset action in there as well, backed by either 6 or 8 gigs RAM, so you can expect a nice silky smooth experience whatever you're up to. The app should just load up instantly. And apparently ZenUI actually optimizes the general performance for a lot of the most popular apps out there as well. So yeah, so definitely hoping for a nice smooth experience no matter what you're up to. And of course, a good bit of PUBG Mobile and all your usual popular mobile games should hopefully run a dream. So there you have it. That in a nutshell is the Asus Zenfone 6. I'm absolutely exhausted now. As you can see, it's 11 p.m. and I've got to still edit and upload this video. Excellent, so I'll go and do that now. But definitely if you've got any comments and everything, what are you thinking about the Zenfone 6? Definitely liking that snazzy camera tech. Something quite innovative, a bit different. So yeah, actually for the €499 plus asking price, pretty solid bit of hardware. So yeah, it'd be great to hear your thoughts down below. And don't forget to poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Cheers everyone, love you.